you know, there's this misconception out there that somehow, you know, everybody in the world's dream is to be able to qualify for SNAP. You've hit the jackpot. It's just like this incredible benefit. It is not this overly generous benefit. The other thing, other misconception that people think is that everybody on SNAP is not working. There are millions of people who qualify for SNAP who work full-time. They work. I mean, given the choice between working full-time and earning enough so you can buy whatever you want, or working full-time and qualifying for SNAP, I mean, I think we'd all rather earn a better wage. And so this is not, you know, this idea that SNAP creates a culture of dependency, or that it's, you know, it's just this overly generous benefit, or the new thing now is that people who hit the lottery are now, Senator Pat Roberts of Kansas just introduced a bill that one of the sections is that lottery winners can't qualify for SNAP. I mean, give me a break. You're a millionaire. You're a millionaire, and you're going to buy, you're not qualified, but you're going to try to scam the system so that you can wait in line and use your debit card and have everybody look at you, you know, as you try to pay out, you know, pay for your groceries. I mean, it's really insulting. But there's a diminishment of this program and a demonization of this program that worries me greatly, because I am very nervous that, you know, in these budget talks in the coming weeks and months, that this is going to be on the chopping block even more than it is right now. And I think that would be a cruel fate to be able to tell families right now who are on this benefit, we're taking it away. And, you know, and there aren't enough food banks, there aren't enough churches and synagogues or mosques in this country to pick up the slack. I've learned a lot from the people in this film. I got to know some of these people. I learned a lot from the witnesses that came to Washington that told me about their life stories. You know, we all have a lot of things in common. We all love our kids. You know, we all care about our kids. And their hearts break every night because they're not sure they're going to have enough food to put on the table for their kids. That should not be in this country. It doesn't have to be.